Welcome to Gunma. Gunma may be a landlocked prefecture in the Kanto region, but it's famous for its many high-quality hot springs and rich industrial history. Let's explore Gunma. Right now, I'm at Kusatsu Onsen. Now, Kusatsu Onsen has some of Japan's largest flow of natural hot springs, which is really interesting. Right in the middle of town is what is considered to be the symbol of Kusatsu itself, the Yupatake. In Kusatsu, there is an ancient tradition called Yumomi, which is the method used to cool the water for bathing. So in order to cool it down, they stir the water with long wooden planks. I'm right in front of the first onsen gozanyu, and I'm gonna go check it out. Also, the air here smells so strongly of sulfur, which is usual for an onsen town, but still, it stinks. Thank God we have to wear masks. This is by far the coolest onsen towns I've been to. Onsens literally are running through the entire town. And it's not a small town either. Takumi no Sato is an arts and crafts village set amongst the rice fields and apple orchards of the Minakami Mountains. Scattered throughout this small village are more than 24 workshops and stores, all within walking distance of each other. You can shop for various Japanese crafts, as well as learn how to even make your own. The workshops typically take about an hour and cost anywhere from 500 to 1,000 yen. During the time of my visit, however, many of the shops were closed, so I opted to make my own little lantern made with hand-woven silk. Now I am at the Tomioka Silk Museum in Gunma Prefecture. The reason why the Silk Museum is actually built here is for five different reasons. First, this area had enough cocoons to produce the silk. It had a nearby water source, coal reserves, and enough land for them to even build this factory. And most importantly, the fifth reason is that the locals allowed foreigners to come build here in the first place. So yeah, let's explore the Tomioka Silk Museum. The city of Tomioka is the site of Japan's first modern silk factory, established in 1872. Not only is the Tomioka Silk Mill Japan's oldest modern silk reeling factory, it was also one of the world's largest silk mills at the time of its construction. Behind me is the silk reeling workshop where a lot of the Japanese women would work. I just learned they initially had a lot of trouble hiring women to work here because they were convinced that the French people were drinking blood, but they weren't. They were just drinking wine, but wine wasn't a popular thing in Japan, so no one really knew what it was, so they thought it was blood. And I just think that's really funny that they thought the French were basically vampires. The Shorin-san Durumaji Temple is the origin of the Takasaki Duruma doll, which is one of Japan's famous talismans of good luck in Japan.
Look at all the Duruma! This is why they call it the Duruma Temple, because they're literally everywhere. Well, I've never seen this many Duruma before.
Daruma is the Japanese name given to Bodhidaruma, the famous, if semi-mythical, Buddhist monk and founder of Zen.
I can kind of see the resemblance. Can you see the resemblance? One really cool thing that I learned here is that a lot of the donumas you can purchase here are, they don't have eyes. Their eyes are blank. And that's because when you purchase one, you paint in the left eye with a goal in mind. And when you complete that goal or that wish comes true, it's fulfilled. So then you can paint in the right eye. So the saying, "Duruma with open eyes" in Zen culture means the attitude towards success and wholeness, which is interesting.
Thanks for watching! If you liked the video, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe.
As glad as I am that there's English pamphlets everywhere, I'm just honestly glad that I can use them as fans because it's so hot.